When Phish gets up on stage, we're a music for the sake of music entity. People need just music in their lives.
I mean, in terms of the flavor name, fish food, I mean, the flavor name could not be anything else but fish food.
I feel like Ben and Jerry's has been incredibly lucky to be connected with Phish. The band and their music and their fans and everything they stand for is right up our alley. It's a great association.
Let's get Ben and Jerry out here to help us out with this one here. Ben and Jerry.
Neither Jerry nor I could get the tune right. They kept on going over and over and over it with us, and we just couldn't get it in our head. And then finally they said, well, strong and wrong. That's what we always say, strong and wrong. Just go out there and do it loud.
We were proud to be from Vermont. They were, you know, Ben and Jerry's was like the one exception where it was like, well, maybe this makes sense for the right reasons. This is really the only time that we have given our name to a product.
This is just the bucket.
I remember there was an interview with Paul Newman. He was just starting Newman's Own. I guess the people around were like, look, if you put your face in the bottle, it, you know, it'll sell more. And so he felt like, well, if that was true, then it would be tacky to keep the money. So he figured that was a trade-off. I recalled that at the meeting when we were first talking about doing the ice cream and all that kind of stuff. The fact that it was going to be doing this thing that was kind of in line with what I had read from Paul Newman and stuff seemed to me to be a good idea.
The Ben & Jerry's ice cream flavor was coming along. It was sort of established, well, we're gonna give away the proceeds to something.
I think that it was fairly obvious that there was something going on with the lake. Trey had two little kids, and I think everybody who lives here goes to a beach every once in a while. There had been quite a number of beach closings.
You hear it about a lot in the news. A bunch of raw sewage ended up in the lake again. Lake Erie was in the news where I was growing up. I mean, there were sections of Lake Erie that would be on fire, or like, I mean, that place is, you know what I mean? That's like the three-eyed fish in the Simpsons episode type lake, you know? And Lake Champlain was no Lake Erie, you know what I mean? But you didn't want it to become that way.
Something can look fine and it can actually be in trouble. And that's definitely true of Lake Champlain right here where we sit. We have phosphorus runoff from farms, from overdevelopment, and from wastewater treatment, sewage treatment plants. That phosphorus fuels plant growth and algae growth, which can create noxious conditions and conditions that cause fish kills that can be toxic and dangerous to people and to pets and other animals. Waterwheel has really been in it for the long haul at a level that allows us to be change agents on the water, but also in the hearing rooms and the courtrooms and where policy is done, so that we're at the most positive moment that I've seen in 25 years working on Lake Champlain.
We love to support folks that are doing something very positive or unique, organizations who feel as though they have a responsibility to their community. Half the money that comes in comes directly from the fans. It really is about everybody in the community giving a little bit that turns into something that's fairly substantial that then can make a difference. And that's very cool.
Whether you're a rock band, a corporation, an individual, if you have anything to offer, you should.